Hello everyone, welcome to the Smarty Techie. In previous video we have checked how to connect our Mongo instances using our Java code, but we have used URI format to connect to Mongo and it was without authentication. So in today's topic we will check how to connect Mongo, but we will use it authorization there. So before using an authorization, you should have a username and password to connect to any DB of it. So for creating a new user, it should be necessary that your Mongo instances, your Mongo DB having enabling the auth and you have a permission over it. So let's get started on this. And before starting, we should have it, we should enable auth on our MongoDB. So that is a document over it. You can check, here is enable auth document. So what we have to do, whether it is replica sets or sharded cluster or any you are using any standalone application, you should have authentications. For replica set and sharded cluster, you require internal authentication between members when access control is enabled. So firstly, let's get started with the standalone function. In the standalone MongoDB, firstly start your Mongo. So what we have to do now, firstly we will enable auth on our Mongo system. But before enabling auth, you should have one user which have the authorization on all the DBs. For example, you should have a user which having roles like using any database, root, admin, any these type of roles. So what we have to do, use admin, that means that we are using the admin database. So and after using admin database, create the user administrator. What will it can contain user which has the role as user admin any database, user admin any database, and it having the right of read write any database. You can provide the root access as well, admin DB admin access as well, but please it should be only given to the user which is having the admin's rights on it. So try avoiding giving these roles to another users so that it will be good for your system. So firstly, for creating any other users or enabling any authorization on your Mongo, you should have one user which have all the roles, which have all the rights permissions to create any user, drop, delete, every permissions on any database. So what we will do, we will create a user on admin database. It should be, for example, my user is Smarty Techie user. Maybe I'm giving it so the example as, for example, qwerty@3221$. Role is user admin in a database and DB is admin, and giving the permission as read write any database. So it will be my user. Let's create on it. So you can check, it has successfully added the user as Smarty Techie user, role this, DB this, and access is read write any database. So we have created a user which having authorization on admin. So we can enable authorization. You can enable authorization in two ways. One way is either restart your MongoD instance with --auth command, or if you are using your configuration file, you can enable authorization or security.authorization. Let's see how you can do auth like this. You can copy from here and you can do it. Now I'm showing you as configuration file changes. So my configuration file, it is come outside from it, vim etc. It should be mongod conf. So you can check, it is a configuration file of your MongoDB instances system, which has been located in your system. It is my local host MongoDB, so I am getting it here. If you are having any server IP, server location, server host, you will get their configuration as well on the specified location. In my terms, it is present in my etc location. It should be present in your etc as well if you have installed in your system. So there are number of configuration. Here is a storage. If you want to change, for example, this is storage for how to store the data. If you want to change the path, you can change here. General, this is the login data, login file path, network interfaces, process management. But now what we have to do, we have to enable authorization. So according to the document where we can enable it, it is a security.authorization. So here is a security. Here it is. Enter. Copy it from here. Paste and write it as enabled. Okay. Please be ensure about the spaces. It will not execute it if you have any error on it. So what we have done is security authorization, and what we have done is enabled. If you want to disable it again, then firstly comment it from here and then restart your Mongo service again. I have enabled it. Okay, it's a read only option, so I need to open it using sudo command. I will do it again. So now it has been executed. Now we have to execute it as well. So you can check here what you can do. There are two ways, by using --- auth, or you can change in the security.authorization in your configuration file. What we have done is we have changed it in our configuration file. So now clients that connect to this instance must now authenticate them as well. So let's restart our Mongo service. Sorry, we are starting it again. Service MongoD restart. So it has been successfully started. So now what we have to do, let's check it has been enabled or not. Mongo. Okay, it has been for example, I want to use my collection as subscribers list. Subscriber list it was my collection, and I want to use admin and db dot. For example, I want to use db dot. Okay, use my database name is Smarty Techie, and we want to get db dot what was my collection name is subscribers list dot find. So you can check here, it is giving an error as not authorized on Smarty Techie to execute command. It has been occurring because we have enabled authorization on our system on MongoDB instances. For what we have to do, we have to create another user which can access to this DB. For example, if I want to, you as in the previous video, you know that I have created an example structure which was getting database and getting collection from it and then find the document from this. But now if I'll execute it, check, you can check here. If you want to execute it, you can check not authorized. That is, it should know that what is the username and password to get authorized over it. So let's create an username. For creating a user, you should authorize to it using the using your user which we have created before enabling the authorization. What was the username? The username was Smarty Techie user. Okay, so how we can authorize to use admin, as it has the access on admin database. Use admin, then db dot auth Smarty Techie user, and what was the password for it? The password for it is this. So it is giving 1, that means it has been authorized successfully. If it has been giving 0, that means it is not authorized, it is not getting authorized to the database. Now using this user, we can create another user which have the access on Smarty Techie DB, and using that username and password, we can enable it using in our application as well. So let's create another user which can authorize on Smarty Techie user. Let's create another user. For example, my username will be app user. So because we are using, we are using this user in our application, and password, let's make it same as well. And user role, what we want to give the role is only read and write. Why we are giving this role? As in my application, if I'll use this user, it should be having the permission on read and write on this DB only, not on admin. For example, I wanted to give the user admission on user authorization on Smarty Techie only, so it will not be able to connect to another DB. So let's give it here Smarty Techie. Don't want to give from any role from here, not access. So it is copy. Let's create this user on Smarty Techie. To use Smarty show collections, okay, it's giving the details of collection as I am connecting to this user, as it has access on all the DBs. So let's create a user on Smarty Techie database. Paste. So now you can use this user in your application as well, as it has the authorization on Smarty Techie DB and having the permission as read and write. So we have created this user in our system for authorizing on Mongo instance. Okay, but why it is giving this error? As I have already connecting this without using any authorization, but after this we have created an user and it should be now connecting using any username which has been provided to the user. So let's meet on another video. We will check how to connect in our RoboMongo to connect to the authorized table or DB, and we will do the same in our application code which has been given here. So do not forget to check my next video. For now, bye bye, take care.